crazy.
Do you get that kind of enthusiasm wherever you go, or is the Big Breakfast the place that really holds a candle?
This is the only place.
Oh.
So how are you? After that sort of reception, are you well?
I'm good. I only got 2 hours sleep last night, but
hey,
I'm doing all right.
You're lucky. You're telling that to the wrong group of people. They manage 2 hours a week, mate. They're lucky.
How long are you going to be in this country?
I'll be here till Sunday.
Oh.
And how's it hanging?
Pretty well.
Okay. You know, Lisa will be chatting to you a little bit later on in the show. That is a guarantee.
Okay. And but in the meantime...
Zig and Zag and Jordan Knight, ladies and gentlemen.
And now their lead singer has launched a spectacular solo career. Please welcome to the Big Breakfast, Mr. Jordan Knight. Now, your debut single, Give It To You, has had rave reviews, both here and stateside, if I can say that.
Yes.
Do you feel that the critics are finally on your side?
It's kind of too early in my career. I guess when I get a little more successful, they might not be. No, but actually in Rolling Stone magazine, a magazine that has never given the new Kids on the Block a good review at all, gave my record a really good review, so... It's, it feels good.
Well, let's judge for ourselves. Here's a little clip of it. Now, you've got hip-hop there. You've got a bit of Beatles.
Yeah.
Am I right in thinking there's a tinge of Queen?
Yeah, there's a part at the end that goes, everything on mine.
Yeah.
Like, that little thing at the end is very Queenish.
Your own homage, perhaps.
Homage. What's that?
To sort of like get on your knees and sort of like say thanks to somebody who's gone before you.
I've said thanks to many people in that song.
Let's just draw a veil over that. Now, New Kids were phenomenally successful. They really were massive. Do you feel like you've got a lot to live up to because of that?
No, I have a lot to... No, not really, because I think, you know, it was five members and it was, you know, a phenomenon. It was such a big group and I don't want to compare my solo career to that career because it would be kind of stupid for me. It was just so big that I would rather not do that. I just want to kind of challenge myself and kind of, you know.
Yeah, I
do know. Just be better every day myself.
Well, you've grown up, haven't you? But you've had all this as a background. But have you forgotten just how big New Kids on the Block were? Have a look at this.
A lot of fun.
Any great particular memories?
I think the best memories were just us just doing weird things, just like our little shenanigans that we just, you know, the little jokes that we had on stage. Sometimes we would just be on stage and tell jokes and the whole crowd would not know what we were talking about.
Because they were screaming.
Are you taking my shoes? Is there like stuff on the bottom of them? Are they clean? Okay.
Hope they're clean. It'll be murder. In your heyday, you were the world's wealthiest entertainer. We always have to pick up on money. Then the success virtually disappeared overnight because something else came up. But what actually happened?
What actually happened was we just broke up. We just, you know, we reached our pinnacle where we wanted to go as a group, and we all figured we wanted to do separate things, and that's what we did.
So do you still see the others?
I see them quite often. Actually, when I was filming the video, Donnie lived right around the corner, so like I had lunch at his house when we filmed that video. And Joe has the record out now, so, and we're always crossing paths. I see him, and I talk to Danny, and of course I always see my brother John.
Mm. So it's all right, though. There's no bad feeling.
No bad feeling.
Because the split was actually 5 years ago, wasn't it?
Something like that.
So why did you wait till now to launch your solo career?
I just took some time off, you know, after all that chaos and everything, and there was a lot of demands placed on me. A lot of record companies were calling me and wanted to sign me as a solo artist, and I just wanted to take my time to figure out what I wanted to do, and it took me a little time, but I finally figured out I wanted to do a solo record, and I just did it. And I wanted to make sure I was doing it with the right people also.
Mm.
So I just took my time to do it.
Well, what did you do in the meantime then, in the 5 years off?
A whole bunch of stuff. Actually, the record was actually recorded. The whole record was done last summer, so that was like a year.
So this is old news to you?
It's kind of an old record to me.
Yeah.
My second single in the States I recorded 3 years ago, so I was like working on music all that time.
Now, I know you used to sing in a Boston bar. I also know that you wrote a chart-topping American hit, didn't you?
Yes. I actually wrote, that was like one of the first songs I wrote on my very first keyboard that my mother bought me when I was 16. And I was 17 when I wrote it, and a guy that was on tour with us when I was around 20 was making a record. His name's Tommy Page, and he asked me if I had any songs, you know, that could go on the record. And I said, yeah, I got a great song. It's called I'll Be Your Everything. And I played it to him. He liked it, and we recorded it, and it went right to number one.
Well, I mean, fantastic. Does it get any better?
No.
However, you are such a huge star here at the Big Breakfast House that we have prepared for you the greatest honor that any quality breakfast show can bestow on a guest.
Uh-oh.
If you'd like...
Do it right.